We sing hallelujah. Hallelujah. We sing hallelujah.
Worship. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, it's all about you, Lord. It's all about you.
the presence of our God. Just focus your mind to our God. Knowing just you,
yes, Lord,
something that of word that will bless you. We sing, I bring you more than a song, Lord.
Hallelujah.
I bring you more than a song, for the song in itself is not what you have required. God will see your heart. Much deeper we may to the way things happen. You're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship. It's all about you. It's all about you. Hallelujah. I'm sorry. Lahat namin naramdaman, Lord God,
all about. Sumbong namin lang sa'yo, Panginoon. Give us heart of worship.
I'm sorry, Lord, for the things I made. It's all about you. It's all about
you. Come on, Josie. I'm sorry, Lord.
I'm sorry, Lord, for the things I made.
It's all about you.
It's all about you. It's all about you.
I'm coming back.
I'm coming back to the heart of worship. It's all about you. It's all about you.
I'm coming back.
I'm coming.
My dear brother and sister, we try to focus our mind to our God. We say, Lord, it's all about you, Lord. We're here, Lord God, because it's all about you, Lord God. No matter what happened, Lord God, we will still serve you, Lord God. Because sa buhay namin, Lord, it's not about the money, Lord God, we have. It's not about what property we have, Lord, but it's all about you, Lord God.
It's all about you.
Sabihin mo, Lord.
It's all about you. It's all about you.
Come on, church.
It's all about. It's all about. It's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. It's all.
Lord, you deserve the highest praise, Lord. It's all about you, Lord God. It's all about you, Panginoon. Hallelujah. Kahit anong pagsubok sa buhay, Panginoon, pilit kami tumatayo, Panginoon. Alam niyo ang buhay, Panginoon. It's all about you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Lord, thank you, Lord God, for giving us the heart of worship. My dear brother and sister, God is looking always into our heart. Hallelujah. Nakita ng Panginoon ang puso natin kung marunong mo tayong magpuri sa Kanya. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, and we give back the glory and honor, Lord God. Just need to pray.
Amen. 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 Because it's all about Jesus. And it's a wonderful thing that we can gather together. The Bible says He inhabits the praises of His people. Are we blessed this morning?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Thank you for bringing Pastor James. It's all about the song. It's all about Jesus. Nothing we can boast of ourselves. All about Him. All about what He has done on the cross 1,000 years ago. And my beloved, without further ado, I'd like to request all the kids to come forward and pray for the kids. Thank you, Jesus. So the kids, they are grown up. Before Stephen mentioned like this, John, now, John is already in nature. And then I go. Thank you. Let's go play kids. Father God, thank you, Lord, for this wonderful, beautiful, handsome children, Lord, that you have made. Thank you so much, Lord, for being our children, for pastor. Thank you, Lord, for blessing us, Lord. And we pray, Lord, for these kids that you will grow in the knowledge of you. You will grow in the knowledge of your word. You will grow, Lord God, into the maturity of our Lord Jesus Christ. That we will be go out to the world, they will represent you, Lord. And I pray, Lord, that you will protect your children from this, Lord, from the evil one. And I pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus, guide them and give them the mission. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So the kids will each will be here. Stay here, okay, just for today, okay, praise the Lord. So let's have our testimony. So who will give the testimony what the Lord has done this week? Any? Only one.
I refuse to wait for that man. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I have testimony for this week because as you know that my wife is pregnant. No, I thank God because last couple of months, when I know that my wife is pregnant, and I tell my wife to stop working, and she said to me, no, I need to work for 6 months so that we can avail the maternity leave. And I told her that it's not possible because you're working the night shift, and imagine we'll wait for this one for almost 12 years, and I don't care about the maternity leave, just stop working. I said no, stop because this is a real, blessing, the work, but. We never think to apply maternity leave because they said, you need a lot of people. Maybe the friend to Berna, I said, you need to work 6 months because that's what I did before to have the maternity leave. But one of the, we having baby shower last Sunday, and one of my friends said, try to call ERD. We don't know. And when we try to call ERD, IRD, and they say that we are eligible. Why? Because you need to work in 26 weeks, but the count is 1 year. And when they counted, you know what happened? When they IRD counted, starting from November 21, 2023, because the due date is 2024, November 21, it's 26 weeks and 3 days. That is.
Amen.
And the requirement is 26 weeks.
Wow.
And imagine our plan is, she said to me that after February, I try to work again. So, you know, already that she planned to buy this hole. But I just told me. Because I have to buy this one. I told her, let's see. Because I don't want to, because my work is really hard because we're farmer and we climb in the mountain. But thanks God. Praise the Lord. 6 months late, with pay. And we're very, very happy. It's 26 years, and I told, I talked to my son. He said, you're very blessed because imagine you came up 26 weeks. Imagine government will pay us for 6 months.
Yes.
How much?
Secret.
26 months, every quarter, they pay us 5,000.
So, anyone else? Give testimony.
Mother Taina.
Good to see you, Ruth. Ronnie. Bless you both. I'm not here to talk about myself. It's all about the Lord.
Amen.
It's all about the Lord, not yourself. We do not honor God enough or respect Him. This place is for God only.
Amen.
You talk about God and Jesus and life.
Amen.
I don't come here to please anybody, but to please the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
You know, the people around the country now today, they don't honor God anymore. A lot of them don't do that anymore. They come to church, they have a good time, entertain each other. We here to entertain God. And Lord only we entertain. We can't take that away from the Lord. Because a lot of people love the praises of men. They love the praises of men. But I'm not here for that. Because don't take God's mercy for granted. Don't take His mercy for granted just because you come to church. God knows who's His sheep. He knows the sheep of the pasture. He knows them by name. And the sheep know His name, His voice when they call Him. But the thing is with the sheep, there are many goats too. Many goats in the sheep today. God is a God. He's not a person to be treated, mistreated. You got to treat Him with respect and holiness and pure. That's what He is. He's a pure God. And that's how we must be treated. We treat Him. That's how we must be also. So, you know, I just come up here to say, you know, this place is for God only. Now talk about yourself. Not praising yourself. This is not a personal joke. We don't joke here when we come before God. Because everything we say or do is recorded in the book. Everything, even idle words. You gotta be careful what you say in this church. Before God. This place is not a place of entertainment. This place is to worship God and to speak His word and spread the gospel. That's what it's all about. Speak His gospel. We're going to thank Him for everything we do. Everything. But the few of us that are not doing that. See, how many times have you repented? How many of you have repented to God? How many are we still struggling with sin? How many are we still struggling with sin? God wants us to be a perfect people. He wants us to be a holy people. People say that, oh no, we can't be holy. That's an excuse. You know, God will not excuse you for that. But He commanded you to be holy. He commanded you to be pure. You can't say, oh no, we can't do that. It's no excuse. It's all written in the book. It's all in the Bible. When He comes, are you ready for Him? Are you prepared? That's what we have to do, prepare, because you know it's not very long before He comes. We don't know when He will come. Nobody knows the days or the hour. Nobody. But don't treat this place like a joke. This is the pulpit of the Lord. May the God have mercy on you. Amen.
Anything else? Anyone else? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Good morning. ang bagay ng sisters. First of all, I would like to give thanks to the Lord for He is a great and mighty. And we got nothing is impossible. Because He answered my all prayer and He gave a good company to work here in Sila. Last Thursday, I took my actual driving test. I'm so happy and I'm surprised. I didn't
expect
but I passed for one
people.
Oh. Thanks to God. Thanks to God.
Amen.
Thank you, praise God. That's your prayer, Father God. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. I am so thankful to the Lord. Last Monday was my 45th year. God is so good to
sana
me and
to
all of us.
Praise
the Lord. Amen. Amen. So we give our tithes and offering. So the tithes and offering. So we already give the tithes and offering. So you can send it to a bank account or normally. Best is just send to bank account because at the end of the financial year, you will get rebates from the government. So we are so blessed and giving thanks to the Lord for what He has done, and we know that by giving to the Lord, God does not keep it, but He multiplies what we give to Him. Amen. So this is basically what we give to the Lord, He multiplies and He will. Do it exceedingly, abundantly, above all we ask, Lord Jesus. Praise the Lord. Are we ready now?
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord. So without further ado, Pastora Ruth and Brother Ronnie, they've been here in this ministry way back 5 or 6 years ago. So they were the pioneers to have this Bible study at place in Escalpol. So over the years of serving the Lord is giving us this call through the life of Brother John.
Amen.
So we are so blessed. Brother John already passed away 2 years ago, but through his life we are so blessed.
Amen.
And through the people who love the Lord so much. And I believe that your life will be a blessing to others. Just continue to serve the Lord faithfully. So, without further ado, I will give to Pastora Ruth the message of the word.
Thank you, Pastor Dom. It's really a blessing when I saw this pulpit. It reminds me of the days when we started this for the glory of God. I see a few faces here. And it's good that with this one and then two families, and then Tina joined, and that day when we went to John's place, Tina was with us and Brother Norman. We were all in tears, praising and worshiping God. And the following Saturday, he joined the fellowship with us. And you know, those who stayed, I praise and thank God that you are here today, encouraging all these brothers and sisters.
Amen.
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 Because when the Lord Jesus will come, everyone must be ready. Yes. And I agree with Brother Tina. To God be the glory for the things He has done in our lives. I would like to call my husband, Ronnie. He will give also his testimony to us.
Maraming salamat. Maraming salamat sa inyong lahat. You really such a bunch of wonderful and great people here in this place.
Amen.
God be the glory. You know, this place is one of the greatest place also to sing praises and adoration to our living God. Amen.
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 So just feel free, feel at home. Yeah, recently we had this so-called holiday in the Philippines, like 3 weeks ago. And, you know, of course, it's really warm there. Even though we left here in towards the end of August, and we stayed there for like 3 weeks. So 3 weeks is not long enough, but too much for our expenses. So we had to come back here in New Zealand. And you know, God is really great because, you know, when we go somewhere else and you think of holiday, and we think of, you think of something else that you enjoy, God has another plan for you.
Amen.
As the children of God, hindi natin pwedeng set aside yung gawain ng Panginoon. That everywhere we go, God is putting us into a situation wherein we need to express what is inside our heart. And that is the love of God, the love of Jesus. So, we went to several places. I don't want to mention one by one kasi mahaba yun eh. Maraming from north, from Nueva Ecija, down to Davao City, and down to Tacoron, Sultan Kudarat in Cotabato. That's where I was born. By the way, my name is Ronnie Colliado, and I'm from Mindanao, and I studied in Siliman, in Dumaguete. And of course, kilalang-kilala niyo na naman si Ruth, Pastora Ruth. And maybe some of you are, you know, just the first time to meet me. And thank you very much for welcoming us here. And truly, God is great. So, brothers and sisters, God is really good. Putting us in places where God wants us to minister to people who are in need spiritually, especially. And sometimes we are urged to give also to those who are in need. Yung ating blessing financially is not only for us. But God commanded us, put in our heart to share also this blessing from the Lord. So, really God is faithful to us as a family, as a church, and as one nation as well. Amen? Kasi yun naman ang command sa atin ng Panginoon, to preach the good news of salvation to all generation, to any parts of the world. So salamat po sa inyo.
Thank you, Brother Ronnie. Praise the Lord. Actually, I prepared the message when Pastor Roy told me to come here and scheduled us to come here in Huntley. And my heart was excited. But you know, just few days ago, as I meditate on the word, a different message that the Lord impressed to my heart. Have you experienced that? That you go to this place, but the Lord is leading you to another way. And that exactly happened to me when I was meditating on the word. And the word that I'm going to share to you, hallelujah, let's open our Bible in the book of John, chapter 15. This is familiar to everyone, to some of you maybe. John chapter 15, verses 4 until 8. And I'm reading from the NIV version, which says, "Remain in me, as I also remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither you can bear fruit unless you remain in me." In verse 5, "I am the vine. You are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. If you do not remain in me, you are like a branch that is thrown away and withers. Such branches are picked up, thrown into the fire and burned. If you remain in me and my words remain in you," what is the Lord said? "Ask whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. This is my Father's glory, that you bear much fruit, showing yourself to be disciples." And as believers, as children of God, it impressed to me that in abiding in the vine, By the way, that is the title of the message today. We are to be united with Christ, hallelujah, through the new birth. Anyone who haven't received the Lord as their personal and Christ and Savior, I believe of you, all of you here, by the grace of God, you came here because you love the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
So that is my point number one. United with the Lord Jesus Christ through new birth. As we abide in the vine, who is the vine? Our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So the Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, 17, verse 17, it says, but whoever is united with the Lord is one with Him in the Spirit. So we are united in the Spirit, amen, through new birth. We are born again. He is living inside your heart, amen. That's why you feel something different. You can compare your life before, amen. Your life before, someone testified in our church. He said, oh, if only I knew that this is how a Christian before, I should, I wasted many years in my life. And he said, no turning back, no turning back. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. Because as we live in the vine, we need to be born again. We need to be rebirthed. Hallelujah. And our inner man has been recreated in his likeness, in his image, and we have become partakers of his divine nature. That is in 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 4. And because we have this new covenant, we don't have to follow many rules. Amen? There's no more so much list in there. Because we have within us a good shepherd who mentioned while ago here, that God, Jesus, hear my sheep, hear my voice, and then follow me. Amen? And here, that is in John 10, 27. Now, we are with Christ himself. We are one with him in spirit, as much as Jesus loves us and desires us to be involved in our lives. Amen?
Amen.
This is the style of our Lord. Jesus is not like the devil. You know what the devil do? He just enter. He's like a robbery. That's why in John 10:10, what did it say? The steal come to steal, to kill, to destroy. That is the work of the devil. But our Lord Jesus Christ, when he comes to our life, he knocks. Amen? And it says there that draw nigh to God and he will draw nigh to you. Our God is gentle. Amen? He will not just enter into your heart, but he waited. Do you think that God is waiting you for so long? But praise the Lord that you are born again. That you receive the Lord as your personal Christ and Savior. And Brother Tina was saying a while ago, I'm back in the streets. When we were distributing flyers with Papa John, with the late Papa John, many years ago, we started a Bible study at Marinelle and Brother Sam. And then we came to know Brother Boyet and Michelle. And then Norman and Doki joined us. We praise and thank God these two families, Boyet and Brother Norman, they faithfully, when they received the Lord, they surrendered their lives to the Lord with their families. These little children, they were still very young during that time, including Mommy there who has been there. Praise the Lord for your life, Mommy. And Doki is, still feeding this little baby, but now a big boy.
Yeah,
that boy is the answer also the prayer. Amen. In that group, because during that time, we are still starting the small group. We did not expect that it will come out that way. And the good thing is, I want to share to you that Pastor Domino and Sister Jean started Bible study as well in Oriwa. Who would have known that God will bring them here and I in Oriwa? That is how God is great in our lives. We don't know where God will bring you and minister to these people because they need the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Remain in the vine. In other words, it is simple to draw nigh to God. To draw nigh to God, we just turn your heart and mind toward Him in an attitude of faith and obedience. Let us repent for the things what God that we have done against the Lord and acknowledge Him as our Lord and His presence and begin to fellowship with Him by faith. So wherever you are, whether you are driving, whether you are at work, you are in school, hallelujah, you abide in the vine. Amen. The Lord is talking to you. It's not only on Sundays that you abide in the vine. But wherever you go, whatever the Lord is bring, where He brings you, amen, even at home, you can stay in living contact with Him all the time. That in fact, that's exactly what our Lord Jesus wants us to do. To abide. Ibig sabihin, in other words, to remain, to live there permanently. So when we went to Manila in the Philippines, we live in a hotel. But we are not permanently living there. We have to come back to our home. That is where you live. The same thing in our spiritual life. Abiding in Jesus means making Him your permanent dwelling place. It doesn't mean living for Him one day only and the devil will come to your life. And then, again, that is not what God wants us in our life. That we don't conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of our mind in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. So, it is living for Him every day. Do we decide to live for Him every day? I live for Jesus day after day. That is what our Lord Jesus wants in our life. And number two is to maintain living contact with Jesus or a constant living with Jesus. Do we daily have that communication with the Lord? Last night, we had this, we call it growth group or Bible study. And this group, we have Friday and Saturday. And that Saturday, one of the hosts, he said, because we are talking about prayer. And he said, has anyone here really reading the Bible every day and then prayer every day? And there were few people who raised their hand. How about those who did not raise their hand? And he said, I am trying to do, but how did you do it? I have that desire. And to the end, after the lesson, we did not finish that lesson, but after that, we agreed that we will, we have this time together to be reminded, to read that verse, and then meditate on it. So praise the Lord. Because He said, I need discipline in my life. Sometimes we are preoccupied with many things. Why? Because you are, you know, the demand of our work. Now, before I used to work full time in the ministry. And I have more time to pray. And I come here every Saturday. You know, our plan before is just to come here once a month because we think of the distance. But our Lord Jesus Christ is faithful to His servant. And then the Lord quickened my heart. I said, I think we need to go there fortnight. And then later on, it just became weekly, not knowing praying that the Lord will build this church in this place. And I praise and thank God for all of you who are here today. The Lord knows your heart and He will grant it, because as He said, at least it said, if you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask. The Lord honors the desire of your heart. My dear brothers and sisters, continue to communicate with the Lord. Being stable in your relationship with Him, you will know His will. Not that personal motive, but according to the will of God. Amen? Praise the Lord. We will have peace when we have that in our heart. Amen? Stating vitality connected to Him by walking in union and communion with Him. All the time. God is good. Amen. All the time. God is good. Yes, He is faithful to us. It is good to have like gathering like this. Sometimes you might say, oh, I will just watch on TV and join there. But you know, you can watch, you can receive the word, but there's nothing more important than to have a corporate worship together. Amen? It is good to when brethren dwell together in unity, praising and worshiping Him. And the next one is abiding in Jesus, that we are to be abiding in the vine, is that we are victors and not a victim. Amen? Praise the Lord. What we do according to Jesus, abiding Him, in the secret to living peaceful, productive Christian life. It allows us to stop struggling. You know why many people nowadays they just choose to end their life? Because they don't have the Lord Jesus Christ. They don't have hope. They don't know that in the Lord Jesus Christ, there is hope. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. And if it's on our strength, we get tired. Even in serving the Lord, in doing all this ministry, if we don't have the Lord Jesus Christ, if we only do it on our own might, it will end up to nothing. We will struggle. But praise the Lord that you are here today and renewing our spirit and abiding in the Lord Jesus Christ. You are a victor and not a victim. Hallelujah. Amen. And when we do that, we become a branch of like an apple tree. You know the branch of an apple tree? That when it grows, it will produce fruit. Amen. What is the fruit? Apple as well. So once we grow in the Lord, that is how it is with us. As we stay in living contact with Jesus, His life flows through us. They will say, you make a difference. There's something in you, brother, that is different. And they will be interested. Oh yes, because I have the Lord Jesus Christ in me. Are we bold enough to declare that we are the Lord, we are God's children? We are victorious. No, that's why when we come to know the Lord, we need a group where we can be nurtured. And Pastor Domino is here to help you, and Sister Jane and Pastor James. Hallelujah. And this, you know, God is our Heavenly Father. He loves you and me, and He's never going to throw us away or destroy us. He will never. He will lift you up. He is there to rescue you. Amen?
Amen.
But He can't do much to help you if you don't stay in living in contact with Him. You might say, oh, the Lord has forgotten me. Are you sure? He will not forget you. It may be that you forgot His word.
Amen.
It may be that you are not in the vine. So connect to the vine, my dear brothers and sisters. Because when we get out of abiding place, we do not only cease to bear fruit, we fell prey to the world and the devil, and we will experience defeat. And this is the problem nowadays. That's why there is war. they experienced before, and that started their heart. And praise God that we are here today. That's not what God wants us if we are defeated. It's not what Jesus wants us to shrink, but He wants us to grow. Amen? Amen? He wants us to bear fruit. He gave us this major key to abiding with Him. And my fourth point that I want to share to you today, that we are doers of God's word. We are abiding in Jesus. Hallelujah. By doing the word. Let the word abide in you, my dear brothers and sisters. What we do with God's word has everything to do with keeping us from becoming dried up, spiritual dryness. Or sometimes we call it barren branch. There's no, you know what barren branch is? You will not bear fruit anymore. You will not be, parang wala kang gana. There's no excitement. But, you know, remember, when the time comes, of course, we are not perfect. There are times that we feel down. But that is the time that the Lord wants to use you more. Amen? Because the enemy, Satan, is not happy to see you worshiping the Lord. But Amen. The Lord, we are victors and not a victim in the name of Jesus. So the more we steep and give attention to God's word, the more we grow in union with Him. The more we feed on what is said in the Bible and live in light of it, and the more He life can flow through us. Amen? They will see our fruit. Hallelujah. So Jesus said, the word I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. Amen? They are life. Hallelujah. And that is in John 6:63. He also said that man shall not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeded from the mouth of God. Hallelujah. That's in Matthew 4:4. So God's word is a spirit food. So when we feed our hearts on it, God's word does for our spirits the same thing as the like the food that we eat. That is good for the body. Amen. And so it becomes part of us. It builds us up. It builds our spiritual life, and it build make us spiritually strong.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That we are strong in the Lord. It produces faith in us, and when combined with that faith, it releases power of the word in our lives. We don't know this when I was a newborn again. When I'm new in my Christian life, I don't know about this. That's why I'm always defeated. And when I hear something offensive, I just avoid. But you know, as I grow in the Lord, the more we experience all these things, God is raising us up. God is making us more mature as you follow the Lord Jesus Christ. The word is important in our life. And when I enjoy, when I started joining fellowship, joining Bible studies, prayer meetings, and worship service, I am reminded that the word of God is alive. The word of God is active. Amen. And I declare that to you, everyone here, who are here today, let us put in our heart that the word of God is alive in our life. And it is active. Hallelujah. I continually attend the fellowship where the word was. I follow the instruction of God. And it reminded me in Proverbs 4:20-22. It says, my son, attend to my word. Incline thine ear to my sayings. Let not depart from thine eyes. Keep them in the midst of thine heart, for they are life. The word of God is life. Hallelujah. To those that find them, and health to all their flesh. That's why they would say, why? You are, even how, you know, we are struggling during the time when we are with work visa. And, but they said, why you're still happy in spite of what is going on in your life? But the not the end of my life.
Amen.
I have the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I am not a victim. Yeah. I am victorious.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Whatever is going on in your life, you are not a victim. You are victors because
Amen.
You're reading the word of God. Hallelujah. Because it is alive in your life. Amen.
Amen.
Keep attending whatever way that you can grow in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. He will not put you to shame.
Amen.
He will lift you up. So let us follow those instructions today. So we can walk in victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. And since faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God, that means we must keep abiding in His word. Amen? Because, you know, we hear here our preachers preaching to you. You need also to abide. You do it with action. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Faith can't be stored up for very long because abiding can't be done just once in a while. But this must be a lifestyle. Amen? Every day in our life, whatever, do not base on your situation or
Amen.
Your status, but based on what
Hallelujah.
Is in our heart.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. So our first, you know, in our, it becomes the way we think. How is our thinking, my dear brothers? Are we connected to the vine? When a need arises in our life, our first thought are, what does the word is saying to me? Do we read our Bible?
Yes. Yes.
Praise the Lord, we have now all this, what is that, cell phone?
iPhone?
What else? You have all this, and we can already read. You know, it makes us more, but I encourage you to read this book because it exercises your mind and also your faith. And yeah, it's good to read those book, but you know, I have a one of the members in our fellowship, she said, help me, pray for me, because every time I decide to have this devotion, she said, I open the verse and it just popped up about my friend, and then I'm needed to go to my Facebook account. And I said, oh, do you remove that Facebook account? But she said, but I'm, you know, my way of communicating to people. But I know you're communicating with other motive. But you know, after a few months, she said to me, I think you're right. She said to me, I spent so much time
yes.
with my Facebook, but when I began to read the word of God, I focused on it. Now I don't post anymore what is going on in my life every day.
Oh, wow.
Praise the Lord. The word of God is alive and active.
Yeah.
And the last thing that I want to share to you is when abiding in Jesus, our priority, we can draw into heaven's resources. Amen? When we face financial need, we go to a scripture that also contains God's word about financial. Amen? So, I was reading this Philippians 4:19. What did it say? My God shall supply all my needs according to His riches and glory. Amen? And I read, I'm reading in that, and I keep on reading, open the Bible and read it again and again. And put it in front of my eyes and keep them going into our ears and say them with me. I need you, Lord. I know that you are a rich God. I know, Father, that you can do exceedingly and abundantly beyond what I imagine, that when I call to your name, hallelujah, you will show great and mighty things in my life.
Amen.
You know, when we were still on work visa, my son, Josh, my eldest son, is the eldest, my eldest son in the family. He is excited to go to the university. As a parent, it really, you know, touched my heart that his dream is, he will be described. I'm thinking that he might be discouraged. You know, I started my knees from day one that he said to me that, Mom, I want to go to university. And you know, I'm a full-time church worker. And being a full-time church worker, I only receive allowance. But praise the Lord, He is our great God who supplies all our needs according to His riches and glory. And from that day one, hallelujah.
Amen.
I put list of financial blessing scriptures every day.
Amen.
I groan in prayer. And I do what He wanted me to do. I didn't stop. I kept abiding in what God says about finances. And within that year, when He said that He wanted to go to the university, He enrolled as an international student. If you ask me how I got those money, the Lord provided it. Hindi kami utang, but that is the greatness of God in our lives. That when we put our faith in Him,
hallelujah,
you are a victor and not a victim. Amen. The Lord can do great things in our life. The same principle that works in every other area of life. When you need healing, you turn to the healing scriptures. And then you feed them on every day and believe them. That by faith and act on them and they become life and help to your flesh. Ministering to others, I know you can pray for one another. Do not limit the greatness of God in your life. You can pray for them. You fill your heart with what God says. They will lay hands on the sick and they will recover. Then go out and act on the word by faith and watch it come to pass. So some of you might say, oh, I can't afford to spend my time in the Word. I have jobs, I have a school, I have other chores, and lots of natural responsibilities. Yeah, I have to be practical. You might say that. But you know, abiding in Jesus is being practical. That is, reading His Word is the practical that you can do. So when you abide in Him, let God involve in your job. Let God involve in your schooling. Let God involve in everything you do. My dear brothers and sisters, you are no longer limited to the world system that it can supply, but through your connection to the vine, hallelujah, you can live a higher level as citizens of the kingdom of God. Our God doesn't want us to live until just a limited, but He wants us to higher level of calling. He wants us to experience heaven here on earth by choosing to put Him first and living in the light of what Jesus has told us in Matthew 6:33. See? Yes, praise the Lord that you know that word, that we have to seek Him first, that we will not worry and be anxious saying what we are going to eat or what we are going to drink, what we are going to wear, but seek first His kingdom and His righteousness, and all the things that you do will be added unto you. You know, when I was new in this country, there are I live with some of the students, and some of them are struggling to get their visa, and they were still students. And I heard them talking that they will partner with citizen people here in order for them to get their visa. And I said, seek first the kingdom of God, and all the things that you need, the Lord will be added to you. Hallelujah. And I'm blessed to hear the testimony of this brother who testified that he took his, the Lord honors your heart. I took my driving license 3 times, and I paid 3 times as well during that time. But today, you don't have to pay if you take the second time anyway. But seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all the things that we need taken together will be given to you. Amen?
Amen.
So how will you seek His kingdom? By doing the very thing I am talking about. So by determining above all to abide in Jesus, And by staying in living contact with Him and letting His Word abide in us. So when we do that, the kingdom of God manifests wherever we go. Amen? So you might do not be surprised when they ask you, when there are gatherings in there, and they will ask you for prayer, to pray for the food. Or you will do the opening prayer. Do not refuse. Because that is your opportunity to serve the Lord. That wherever the Lord will, oh no, I cannot, ibig sabihin, meaning you are limiting God's greatness in your life. Yes. So anything that is offered to you for the kingdom of God, receive it and take the challenge. Because God has a way of making you more mature and making you, you know, to be, that you will have to be a closer relationship with Him. And as long as we are abiding in Him, we are on His sovereign territory. We are backed by heaven's power and resources and under His protection. And we have given the authority to extend that protection to others. That's why the Lord sent you here in Huntley, majority of us, or maybe all of us who are originally from New Zealand. The Lord brought you here, so praise the Lord for brother here. Because the Lord brought us here for to bring to these people that we do not know, to encourage them, to bring the protection that you don't have. I mean that you have, to bring that, to extend to other people. Amen? You experience peace. Then share to them how you experience peace. You know, testimony is the best gospel that you have. How the Lord Jesus changed you from glory to glory. That He died for you and me. Hallelujah. That He has risen from the dead. He's resurrected. Other religion, if I may ask, did their God resurrected? No, only the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So we are here today. We can lay hands on the sick and they will recover. We can tap on heaven's resources and share to those who are suffering or in need. Simply by abiding in the vine of the Lord Jesus Christ, we can bear abundant fruit and bring great joy to for the glory of God. So what did we learn today? Number one is we are designed, or we are, hallelujah, with my point number one, we are united in the Lord Jesus Christ through new birth. We are in constant living with the Lord Jesus Christ. To be abiding in the vine, we are to be constant living with the Lord Jesus Christ. And another one is, abiding in Jesus, we are victor and not the victim. And the fourth one is we are to be doers of the Word of God. And the last is abiding in Jesus is our priority. We can draw into heaven's resources. To God be the glory for the things He has done in our life. And today, I want to request everyone to please stand. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for reminding us that, Lord, sometimes, oh God, our faith in you, oh Father, is shrinking, oh God. Forgive us, Lord. Forgive us, oh God. Help us to see you, God, that you are a great God, oh Lord Jesus, that we are there, oh Lord, in the vine, oh Father. Thank you for giving us, oh Lord, to the authority, Lord Jesus, to share your word, to continue what you started in our lives. And today, Father, I pray for everyone who are here today that you will, Lord, touch their heart. What you have started in their life, oh Father, it shall continue and grow and bear fruit in the name of Jesus. I pray that you will bless a Huntley outreach, oh Father, that you will bring more people from all walks of life. Lord Jesus, we pray for these children, that they will grow to be leaders, the youth, oh God, these men and women, oh Lord Jesus, that you put them here to serve you, oh Lord, and share your word, oh God, to those who are in need. You will empower them by your grace and mercy. And I thank you, God, that you will continue to strengthen them, strengthen their faith, family I'm representing, you will provide their needs, oh God. Whatever kind of needs they have, I declare in the name of Jesus. You are a great provider, oh Lord. You are a great God who can deliver them from any kind of sicknesses, from any kind of things that is putting them, oh Lord God, that causing them to shrink their faith. But Lord, in the name of Jesus, I pray, oh Father, that you will strengthen them, oh God. That you will defeat the enemy in the name of Jesus. That they are victors and not victims in the name of Jesus. And today, oh God, as we are here today, I pray and declare and decree by the grace of God that everyone will raise, oh Lord Jesus, a mighty army in the name of Jesus. They will fight the enemy because you are here for them in the name of Jesus. Give them, Lord, that love, oh Lord God, and trust in you, Father. Thank you, Father. We thank you and bless your name. And Lord, when we go from this place, oh God, we will be strengthened. We are renewed in the name of Jesus. There is God in our heart who can do everything, who is strengthen us, oh Father. And bless everyone in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord. And I'm so grateful. Okay, you can sit down now. It is my prayer that once in a while I can visit you as well. And we are, during that time, just a few, sharing. That every Saturday, we come here in the morning and then we giving some tracks there in this town and somewhere, wherever the Lord is bringing us. And after that, we come to that hall, hall there. You know, Papa John is bringing us 3 heaters because that place is very cold. That was winter. And baby Kobe is baby still. You know, he's still a baby. And he loves Papa John. Yeah, during that time. And it just reminded me, and I'm refreshed again that, you know, your love for the Lord, He will honor it and He will continue what He has started in this place. I may just be, we are just instrument, but the next generation, let's pray that they will continue what God has started here. And let us continue to support also our pastor and Sister Jean, because as workers, at the same time you are also working, it's not that easy. Because they are also praying for you. You don't see them, but you know there is battle behind praying for you. Whatever your needs, they will not tell you that. I'm the one telling you now because I experience it. And I pray that you will also continue to invite others and be an encourager to those who are in need. Amen? Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Pastor.
God. Are we blessed this morning?
Amen. Amen.
Stay connected. Amen.
Amen.
That's the message, my beloved. Stay connected. Without Him, we can do nothing. But in Him, we have everything. Praise the Lord. Yun po ang message. A very simple, powerful message, my beloved. Stay connected with Christ. Amen. But how? Read His Word, listening to the Word of God, coming to church. What else? Stay connected. Fellowship. Those are the things that we stay connected with the Lord among, also among with brethren in the church. That's our life, our Christian walk. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Pastor Arroz, for the message. And we are reminded. And you see, the Lord will use you mightily. Amen. Yes. The Lord will use you. And this is our prayer, that the Lord will use each one of us here. And one soul is very important. One soul repenting, thousands of angels rejoicing. Amen. Praise God. And thank you. Let's stand and